Russia assuring the Philippines it is willing and ready to help the country boost its defense capability and continue the two countries' close cooperation against terrorism. Following President Rodrigo Duterte's recent visit to Russia, Russian Ambassador Igor Kovaev says Moscow's assistance comes without conditions.
All options are on the table. And once again, no political conditionality, no political linkage. Russia will never teach anyone human rights or something like that. And we'll never use our defense cooperation as a pretext to interfere, to meddle into domestic affairs of other sovereign states.
Without mentioning the United States or any specific country, Russia also telling the Philippines' traditional allies not to interfere in Philippine-Russian bilateral cooperation.
No third country has a right to interfere into our defense cooperation. Because our defense cooperation is not against anyone. It's not against any other country.
Kovaev says both sides are working on the Philippine plan to acquire Russian Mi-17 helicopters. Russia also has a proposal for the joint production of sophisticated light arms and small weapons in the Philippines. Kovaev adds, Russia is also ready to help the Philippines build a submarine fleet. Although there is no energy deal yet, Kovaev says Russia is ready to help the Philippines in developing its nuclear industry.
The final decision always depends, always belongs to our Philippine partners. What we can do is to offer our help, our assistance. But it's up to you, Filipinos, to decide whether you need this help, you need this assistance, or not.
Kovaev says Russia is ready to supply the Philippines with energy resources, including the building of power plants. A group of experts was sent by Russian energy firm Rosneft to Manila last week to discuss the possibility of a joint offshore development with the Philippines, following an invitation from Duterte. But Kovaev says this still has a long way to go. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.